Now that we've received our makeup, what the heck do we do with it? Some of you may have just ordered the starter palette with the four that holds your contour, two highlights, and lip and cheek. Some of you may have ordered more. I'm going to show you the four and the extras, how to place them, how to get started. Now you'll take your tins, open them up just like so, take the lid off, and they're magnetic, and they will stick right in your palette like so. And we're going to start off with contour placement. That contour is a dark, scary color. Not really that scary. It adds depth, dimension, definition, and accentuates those natural features. I placed it along the edge of my forehead, right there under my cheekbones, under my chin, went behind my ear, under my jawlines there, lined my bottom lip, and down the sides of my nose. Now I'm going to go in with my brightening highlights, that which acts as a concealer. Now I've placed that brightening highlight up here in the T-zone, down my nose, the tip of my nose, Cupid's bow on my chin, anywhere where a beard would grow, under my eyes, and I draw a little line, a small tiny line right under my contour to kind of clean that up and make it look lifted and snatched. And I applied my contour and brightening highlight with the detail brush. Now I'm going to go in with my main highlight, which is just my foundation that matches my skin tone the best. So I've applied that main highlight foundation with my powder brush. Yes, my powder brush. Everywhere else where there wasn't any makeup. You can go ahead and add your bronzer and your blush before you blend. Some do. I like to blend first and then add those. So I'm just going to start blending, and I'm going to start with the lighter areas first. And it's okay if you kind of blend your brightening highlight kind of with your main highlight. Just leave that contour where it's at. Bronzer. Now I have used Bella, and I apply that everywhere is where I want it to look like I have a natural glowing tan. I'm putting it right above that contour, kind of hugging it on my sides of my forehead, like in the shape of a teepee or tent, on my nose. You can put it on your chin if you like. I choose not to. And then I'm going to put it down here to connect my face to my neck so it doesn't look like I'm wearing a mask. So I blended that bronzer in with the blush and bronzer brush. And everything I blend, I use a stippling technique where you just pat. You don't want to swoosh it, any of your makeup. You just want to pat. Pat, 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 and pat upwards when you blend. Now I've got my blush, my lip and cheek called Venice. I just applied that on my lips with a multitasker brush because I like that flat end. You can use your finger. And then I've applied it on my cheeks right above my bronzer, kind of hugging my bronzer. Now I'm just going to blend that with the blush and bronzer brush. And now my favorite product, Illuminator. This is the powder. This one is called Photoshop. If you like to glow and shimmer and shine bright like a diamond, I suggest the powder. If you like a more subtle light-catching shimmer, go with the cream. But you apply it right under your eyebrows where it starts to arc over to the edge, in the center, down the nose, the tip of the nose, Cupid's bow. I even dusted some over my lips to make them shine more, and right above my blush up to my temple. And then I'm just going to finish off with some Seint Stay Spray and some Vanilla Dust Setting Powder. The powder, in my opinion, is best for oily skin, and the setting spray, in my opinion, is best for dry skin. But I recommend them both. Have a great day!